Evening, folks. This is Bessel Slot, and welcome back to Black Rock Park. I know it's been a while. It's been 6 days since I even uploaded content onto the channel at all. Unfortunately, I don't know how, but I basically got the flu for like the second time in a month. I've been hallucinating and stuff. It's been a very unpleasant 5 or 6 days for me, so I decided to just basically take it off and try to focus on recovering. I'm not 100%, but I am definitely better than I was, he says, clearing his throat before coughing madly. Good enough that we can get back to work, basically. So that is what we're going to do today, and today is going to be a longer video, and it's basically going to be cleaner. We're not working on anything in particular. Let me just ramp these up. We can probably go up to 15, I think. We've got plenty of animals in our park by now. We're going to do our cleanup. So we're going to do decoration, we're going to do lights, we are going to do some stuff in the exhibits. We're going to work on some pretty cool stuff. We're going to work on the planetarium a little bit. We're going to work on the story of Black Rock, the tale of the ghost, all that kind of cool stuff. So it's going to be a fairly chill little video, I think, hopefully. right then, all that said, let's do some stuff. Now, I haven't really planned this out, I probably should have. But we're just going to kick off with a few lights. Always want to get those roughly equal. I think already I'm seeing a slight fault with that one then. It's a bit more over that way. I still need to decide. So the big decision I want to make at the start is how we're going to light this whole area. We need to obviously put some foresty stuff around here, make that look all nice like. But how are we going to light the area in general? I don't know. I think I want lampposts. I kind of want them to be on fire, but I'm unsure on that. You're hungry, buddy. Can we get a keeper in here, please? Thank you. And we'll keep the game going for once. Power source inaccessible. Yeah. Yeah, I know, it's fine. We're gonna, like, stay unpaused, which is something I don't really ever do. Let's say hello to a couple of people, grab some pointeroonies, lovely stuff. I would like to get this bit done before the lights go off, so let's try to do just that. I've kind of, in several areas, changed how I lay the lights out, which is moderately annoying. I'm not sure why I did that. Bad besting slot. Just grab these. We're going to duplicate those, we're going to rotate those with angle snap on. Chuga, 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 chuga. Like my chugging there. We'll do these bits and then we'll probably wait until the next nighttime to do the actual, the lampposts and stuff like that. I really don't want to cross over onto that a little bit. That'll do. Beautiful, beautiful. I love lights, I do. These aren't even nice, like, I wish I hadn't done this style, you know, this kind of pointing out of the ground with these little white ones that I've done, because I think from down here it looks a little bit, it looks alright. I don't love it though. I'm about to have babies. Well, about to bang it out actually, but I've committed to it so all over the place by this point in time that I can't possibly back out on it, you know? This is why I've been saying next time we do a park, what we're going to do is we're kind of going to design the visual language right from the get-go. We're going to pick the lights or build our own lights, build our own donation boxes right from the start, and then use those across the park. I think it's a really cool idea. I think everything I do is a really cool idea, though. It doesn't mean much. And it never is. Okay, let's just grab those. We're just going to finish putting these in, and then we'll move on to some other cool stuff, hopefully. So yeah, hope everyone's had a good week. I do apologise for disappearing. I don't, like, I know people don't care, you're sick, you should go recover, but I don't like it. I don't like this being for that long. It doesn't feel good. Maybe I'll do a video next time, but in the future, if you were curious where I was and stuff like that, I do have a Twitter, which is linked in the description down below, so if you check that out, you'll always know where I am. Not always, it doesn't, like, have a tracker on me, that would be very weird. Maybe I should get one. Black Rock's looking really cool, I will say. Also, maybe need to sort some animals out. Let me have a look at our animal list, actually. Still, oh my god, so many baby bison. Do we have a male bison? I don't know. There's going to be some incest going on there. Still got bears. Still got pronghorns. Still got wolves. Yeah, cool. Just want to make sure we still got everything going, because I do keep getting rid of things because they keep trying to, like, incest up, basically, and I'd like to avoid the incest if at all possible. Right, so we should, since I want to put lights in here, we should work on this little bit here. This is not going to be anything too fancy, just going to make this look like this, basically. I just want it to look nice and garden-y. I think we should also then bring in my little, I've still got the bloody barrier there. That was when I had flamingos, which were a mistake. I have much regret about flamingos. I mean, I think everyone's got flamingo-based regrets in their lives, though. I don't think that's a big deal. Now, that to me doesn't totally look like it's going to go straight, but we'll see. So we're going to grab these bits. We're going to control X. See, look at that already. Going down there for? What's all that about? It's going to be difficult. Ah! Stop that. Okay, if I remove from group, that actually might explain why you did that. Yeah? No. Okay. Oh my god. Right, Okay, I mean, we can figure this. There's easier ways to do this. We just do this. No. Why is it doing this? I don't... You know, this isn't even that big a deal. Just shut up, business lads. Fine. Just do that. Yeah, look at that. That easy. Okay, now, I believe this works. If we then select all this, and then try to duplicate, it'll work. Yeah, sweet. There's always little tricks you can do. Little things that you pick up from that's... probably not really technically part of the game, but it's kind of stuff you just sort of figure out as you play your way through it. What's going on? See, this is what I mean. Quinoa's about to input. No, stop, stop. Get out. While the baby is watching as well. That's shameful behavior. Quinoa. It's not technically called quinoa, but I'm going to call them quinoa. What I'm tempted to do, maybe when we get baby wolves. Do we have baby wolves? Do we have pregnant wolves? I've got lots of wolves. None of them. Jesus Christ, there are a lot of wolves. I think when we get a few cubs, what we might do, although I don't have any baby bears, it's because Logan's old as balls. Okay, what we're going to do, we're going to get rid of Logan. Sorry, Logan. We're going to grab a grizzly. I have no money at all, so we're going to grab a Bengal tiger first. This is what I do. I sell Bengal tigers, and that's how I fund my park. Don't know where all my cash just went, but... deal with that in a bit. I want a grizzly bear. Grizzly bear, thank you. And I want a young male who doesn't cost me a goddamn fortune, so let's go bronze bear. You know what, that'll do. Will that do? What are you like? You're even better. The franchise, Pendle. Pendle, you're going to go live over there, buddy. I want baby bears, and what we're going to do is we're going to scale down the animal aging, like 5 times or whatever it is. Now, that means pregnancy takes ages, and giving birth takes ages, and all this kind of stuff, but the animals also live much longer. And we can kind of grow attached to them a little bit, and maybe we can kind of have this group of animals that we actually know and recognize, you know? I think that'd be cool. Am I losing money? Am I still doing... No, right, like, I'm just going to keep an eye on that. I have been spending money, which is making me wonder if maybe that's why. Let's just speed things up temporarily. Yeah, I'm... Oh boy, am I losing money. Right. Interesting. I'm losing more than I expected, I'm not going to lie. Why have we become non-profitable? Now, I don't have any donation boxes up there. That's probably not helping. You're in a terrible place. You go over there. This area actually is one of the bits that needs a bit of love as well. I'm just going to stick some donation boxes up here. I was a little worried about this. This area up here, it's kind of like my Penrai. You know, it's excessively big, right? This whole bit over here. So anytime someone like comes down here, this doesn't even lead anywhere right now. It's kind of going to lead to nothingness. What I might do... it's a little bit on the cheeky side, but I am a cheeky person. I might... Just for now, what we're going to do is actually replace... like that, so that our pot guests can't... Basically, this whole area over here is like wasted room, essentially. Like, we don't need this right now, like when it leads somewhere else, sure. But for now, all it's doing is taking my guests away from areas that are actually going to give me money, so... I think we'll do that temporarily, and we'll probably change it up down the line. I don't think that's going to be enough to help, but we'll, see what happens. I don't want to live unpaused, but if I'm going to lose money, then I don't really have a choice. Anywho, back to work. Just gotta get that second one on. I'm not technically sure how it works. I mean, logically, it does make sense to me in my head hole. That's what I call my brain. Stupid bloody rope. Right, I think we can bring that a little to the right. Oh god. And then carry that on that way and just sort of hide it in a tree, I guess. I want to block it off, but I don't really want it to be obtrusive. I think that's okay. I don't really need it across there. Although it probably doesn't hurt. How much does this cost to me? This can't cost a lot, right? What was that, 46? 40, ah, no problem. Looks a bit weird having this across the garden. Which is kind of why, oh my god. It's kind of what I wanted to avoid, but hey, whatever, it's fine. Yeah, it's fine, it's fine. Still losing money. Finances, show me finances. I do have a lot of staff, maybe we should fire some people. Who's not busy? Caretakers. Fire a caretaker. Fire a vet, question mark? Sure. Everyone else is kind of overworked. Where's all my money going? Oh my god. Every year is awful. Income. I mean, I don't have... There's some like basic stuff I don't have. Like, education is actually quite bad. Surprisingly, I thought it'd be better than that. I'm surprised toilet is high as it is. I don't believe I have any toilets in the park. So that's surprising to me. Taxes, habitat area. You know, staff wages is always the worst, it really is. I'm gonna keep an eye on that. I don't think that's... Damn. What we maybe need is more shops, more food shops. Because this is the only set we've got. It's just, I don't want to just stick them in there. I want them to, you know, look good and be decorative and stuff like that. And I can't be bothered. to be totally honest, I cannot be bothered right now. So, let's do some pretty stuff. Grassland. Tundra. Dega. Tempera? Wait, what? No, I don't use grassland. Right? I'm only losing very little amounts of money. I'm going to pause it. I'm afraid. Like, this is how it has to be. So I really want to stick with using the same types of trees. So for now, actually, what we're going to do is just copy and paste a little bit. And we're going to go ahead and turn off a light surface. Make my life a lot easier. So I really want this whole place to feel... Like, we're using basically the same plants for the entire... I love that. Listen to that. Listen to the music. Cool, isn't it? I mean, it's really cool. Not homogenous, but it should feel... thematically... homogenous. No, there just should be a lot of similarities in terms of plant life across the entire park. It's very much part of what I'm going for here. I'm just getting some basic stuff from over here. That is a big boy beach right there. Oof. Can I put that there? Is that crazy? That's crazy. Yeah. Just getting some basic trees, and then we'll go in with our own nature stuff and mix things up a bit. But that is already... looking a lot better. Gonna maybe put some lily pads in there? Yeah, for sure. Let's do a little bit of texturing as well. Not too much. I like to get a little dirty around the... basically, I like it to get dirty where it's wet. I don't really have a better way of putting that. I'm sure I could have thought of a better way of putting that, but I'm not going to. That's the life we have. Okay, so let's see what we can do over here. This area is looking pretty okay. Don't want to go too far here. Oh, what am I about? Of course I bloody do. What's this? Oh yeah, Ewok Village. And he said... I keep meaning to do my showcase videos for, you know, the workshop highlight videos, but... I've just been dead. It's just been difficult to do. It really has. feel bad for me. I can take a week off work because I was sick. A lot of people don't have that luxury. I'm a very lucky guy, what can I say? It's funny, actually. These are long videos, right? We're going to end up talking nonsense. To an extent, YouTube is, don't get me wrong, one of the luckiest jobs in the world. It really is. So much I love about my job that I just couldn't get away with on other jobs, and I get to communicate with you guys, and I get to essentially play video games for a living, you know? There's a lot more to it than that, but that is the crux of the matter. And it's things like taking time off for work where it starts getting a little bit weird, because you'd think, in theory, I can take off 2-3 weeks if I want to. Technically, I could get away with that, right? Without any problems. I just post on Twitter saying, you know, I'm sick, whatever, maybe I'm going on holiday, whatever. I'm going to take a couple of weeks off. In theory, that's okay, because, well, I don't have a boss, I don't have anyone to answer to, you know? If I want to take a year off, technically I can do. And there would not be any direct trouble, per se. The problem, of course, is then you become homeless because I don't get paid. And this is true of, like, every single person on the planet who works for themselves, don't get me wrong. It's just, I think it's a different kind of pressure. It's not one's better or worse than the other, I'm just saying that. It's like, you get this irrational fear of taking time off because, I don't know, it's YouTube, right? You kind of have to keep going. It's this little baby that you grew up yourself, and if you don't keep it going, then it'll die and you'll be sad forever, basically. I don't know. I don't know what I'm on about. Alright, this bit's pretty dumb for me. This was already looking pretty good. Needs a little bit of love over here. I will say, despite what I've just said, I'm immensely lucky to have this job, and, you know, there are people out there who definitely work much more pressurized jobs than me, or ones that require more hours and stuff like that in particular. I think it's always silly to try to compare jobs and what people do. You talk to people who have problems and you go, oh, I feel bad complaining about this because such and such has problems, or, you know, there's people in Africa starving and all this kind of stuff. And yeah, technically, on some level, I guess there's people out there who are having more trouble than you, you know, just because there are people fighting for their lives, people are starving, people are, you know, in war, blah, 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 blah. You know, there are people who have objectively probably harder lives, but that doesn't mean anything, right? Like, they're not you. They're not living your life. And if they could live your life, I'm sure they'd take that opportunity if they could. But they would also then probably suffer from the same problems. I don't know. Like, I think it sounds weird, but suffrage is not suffrage. Suffering is relative in a lot of ways. Just because other people are going through something which a lot of people would consider worse doesn't mean your suffering doesn't count for anything. Doesn't mean your suffering is negated. We all have stuff to deal with for the end of the day. And we've all got to deal with it in the context of our lives. Am I making any sense? It's like 5 in the morning. It's gonna be nonsense. Right, okay, this bit was apparently neglected. That'll do. Okay, so I want to go back over here. I don't really want to do too much here, actually. There's not much in the way of land. There's a little bit over here that needs a little bit of love. I'm going to try to stop using Labrador tea. I do love the Labrador tea, and it's definitely the flower for this park, more than all the others. I don't mind using it. I'm going to do a little arrowwood bit. I mean, it's pretty cool stuff. My point is, though, don't, like, if you've got problems, just have problems. Like, don't feel bad about it. It's fine. Don't feel, okay, I mean, people can complain too much, blah, blah, blah. That's not my point, but, like, you shouldn't feel bad because you've got issues, because other people may have it worse. That's nonsense. I don't blame people for feeling like that. I know a lot of people who feel like that. It's all relative. That's all. Isn't that a TV show? No, that's a TV show on Friends, I believe, right? That's all relative. I think, isn't it the one that Joey hosts? Is that Bamboozled? I swear I remember him going, that's all relative, but I may be thinking Bamboozled. Oh, I don't know. It's been a while since I watched Friends. So, this is fun. you'd have got like a whole exhibit by now if this was a speed build. But you do get to hear much, much less nonsense on a speed build. So, for those who appreciate the nonsense, this will be a better video. For those who don't, you're probably not watching this bit anyway. So, Okay. The other people are cooler. I do want to do that bit as well. Obviously, this has to be some... I might make a little thing here. That should be a thing. It's cool. I'm not sure what it's going to be. But we'll come up with something. Look, look. I didn't sink it into the ground. I'm a madman. I'm looking at it. I'm like, I kind of want to sink it into the ground. But I'm going to resist. I hate that. When you click, and if you don't click off completely, off the shift key before you left click, then it'll stick, basically, the nettles, and it's actually super annoying. I can see why it is like that. Oh my god. But it means you have to quit off, and it's a pain. Oh my god. It's a pain in the ass. Okay, I think we need to bring some rocks in, and then we'll bring in... I don't want to bring in the lilies until we bring in the rocks. Just because, the rocks will, to some extent, determine where the lilies actually go. I want to do just a little bit over here. Where's my beloved diamond leaf? Hello, my beloved diamond leaf. I love it. I really, like, in case you didn't get it from that, I love this stuff. This one in particular, this is my fave. The third one's the best for leafage like this. But the middle one's the best for placing into rocks. You'll see what I mean in a bit. Message sensor? Not on my watch. Right. What was I using? Temperate? Temperate, cool. Boop, boop, boop. What I really wish you could do is have like a saved filter set. Can you have a saved filter set, I think? What's this? No. What's this? No. Ooh. Huh. I don't think you can. Obviously you can have... What's this? You can have favourites, like they set with this, but that's not what I want. I want a saved filter. I want to be able to click a filter and it'll be like temperate... Like, if I could have a saved filter that was temperate, tundra, and taiga... Tiger? North America, which is the foliage I've used for, like, this entire bloody park, and I could just click one button and it would load that set, that would actually be super, super, super helpful. So maybe, then, hopefully, that's something we get down the line. That would make me very happy. Frontier, if you're watching for some bizarre reason, can you do that for me? Thank you. I say that, but they didn't listen to me when I asked for P for Path on Jurassic World Evolution. They're not going to listen to me now. Oh, Nick. Can't believe you've forsaken me like this. I'm going to put that there. I'm going to sink it down. Are we going to say, I don't know. I quite like it like that. It's fine like that. Do you need a baby on you? Let's find out. Yes, you do need a baby on you. Okay. Who doesn't? I might know. We're not making that. Okay. Let's sink some rocks down. I've missed the game. I've missed everything about YouTube. It's only been a week, but... I mean, it's not like I've been slacking, don't get me wrong. It has been a rough old week on me. Like, I was literally hallucinating and... should have gone to a doctor, but I didn't. I think it was just the flu, but I did have the flu. Like, you remember, I missed probably mid-November, early-ish December even. I missed a little bit of recording. I don't know how long it was. About 5-6 days again, probably. And, really don't think I would have got the exact same thing again, so maybe it was something else. It did feel a little bit different last time. I had this like horrendous cough, which isn't typically very flu-like to get a cough. This time it was more severe headaches and hallucinating, which is probably caused by the headaches and the sweating and the fever more than anything else. It's been fun, yeah. Hope everyone else has had a better start to their year. Saying that, you know, 2020 has been pretty cool so far. It was meant to be the year where I really get started on the channel. I'm actually setting up a little business in February as well, hopefully, which whether I'm going to talk about on the channel, I don't know, but we'll see. Ow, 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 the wire still attacks me. Ow, ooh. Go away. We'll have to see, but, you know, it's a possibility. What was I saying? I don't remember. I really want to crack on with the channel a little bit as well, and then I died. Like, unfortunately, I died, so it made it a little bit more difficult. What are these called? Just water lily, okay. Oh, sweet. Oh, I've got two types. Right, I want the common, I guess. So I just want to do that. The same thing we do with the plants on the land. I really like to bring them in so they are by the rocks. Now, technically they're in the shade, and maybe that's not science. But it's worth mentioning the sun does, in fact, move, and the Earth moves around the sun, as we know from science and such. So just because in the shade now doesn't mean they always are. I just think it looks cool. Speaking of which, well, not really, but let me talk about something while I'm putting lily pads down. Those who don't know, so obviously I'm a YouTuber, this is my job, has been for a long time now, 8 years, whatever, but I've always been very much of the opinion that I should have, like, I love doing this, but I've always wanted something else in my life as well. Like, don't get me wrong, I'm not going to get on YouTube, and I'd very much like to keep doing this for as long as I possibly can, but I also like the idea of doing other things. I was, for a long time, doing law and studying law at a very, very high-level university. I have decided against that for a few reasons I don't totally want to go into right now, but to sum it up, it would be... How do I describe it? It would kind of be like a lifestyle that I want for the wrong reasons. Like, I think... to work at a high level in law, and that, like, at the end of the day, I went to a prestigious university because I wanted to work at a high level. I don't really care about that kind of stuff, but to get into the top firms, you know, it helps to work at a very... It helps to have gone to a good university. It's just the way it is. So that's kind of the whole reason I went in the first place. And I started thinking about it, and I just kind of realized, you know, that, yeah, maybe I'll, you know, graduate, do well, whatever, blah, 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 blah. And then I'll be working, like, honestly, to do well in, like, city law firms, you're going to work 14-hour days and weekends and constantly. And I want to travel and focus on family in a few years and stuff like that. I don't want to be spending my entire life in the office. And to get to the top level, that's kind of what you have to do. And I'm not really in, off the... Like, I don't... like. I don't know if this sounds makes me sound like a bit of a dick, and hopefully it doesn't, but I don't really want to do something unless I'm going to commit to trying to be the best at it, or, you know, doing it at a high level. So it kind of became unattainable to me in a way that it doesn't fit in with what I want from life. So I did scrap that. I don't think I've actually mentioned that on the channel, so there's some news. For those who knew, I was doing law anyway. It's what these videos are going to be like, by the way. I don't know why, I just feel the need to justify it every now and again, but I think if you're here at this point, you're probably used to it by now, anyway. I mean, what am I going to talk about putting lily pads down? What am I going to say about that? Nothing. Grumble. Alright, let's do this bit here. This is just going to be Labrador tea, I'm pretty sure. Also, where's my drink? I need a drink. We're going very casual for these videos, okay? Oh god, I need a drink. Whew. Also, to complain, these should be organized. I've just realized they're alphabetical and that makes more sense, so I'll shut up. I'm thinking, though, they should be organized by, like, temperature. That'd be cool. Whew. Do I just want to use Labrador? I'm pretty sure I just want to use Labrador tea here. Not like that, though. Sink it down. It just looks so much better! And the Labrador tea is very much what I've been using, you know, in the entire park, so I think it makes a lot of sense. What? Oh, right. Actually, that's a better way of doing it, yeah. What was I saying? Oh, yeah, anyways. So, honestly, like, me not really knowing what I want to do with my life has been, like, a running theme. Like, you talk to my dad or, like, any of my family. It's been a thing for a long, long time now. I'm very lucky I found YouTube. You know, I love YouTube, but I'm also not totally convinced that this is something I can be doing in 10 years' time. YouTube's very ephemeral, you know. It could be, you know, bigger channels than mine have disappeared overnight. It's just the way it is. Now, obviously, I hope that never happens, but... I think it makes sense to be prepared for the worst. I think it makes sense to have a backup and hopefully something you're passionate about, you know, something you care about. And I'm very, very lucky and fortunate, I won't pretend otherwise, to be in a position where I can continue to work on something I already love, like YouTube, but also, on the other hand, kind of be searching to find more work, again, in something that I'm passionate about. A lot of people have to worry about family and putting money and food on the table. Don't put money on the table for food, that would be weird. And can't, you know, go spend 3 years doing another degree and stuff like that to get the job of their dreams, because at the end of the day they have responsibilities. I'm very fortunate that I can do YouTube and currently don't have a... I'm very lucky that I'm going to die alone. I'm very lucky I don't have to worry about that kind of stuff quite yet. Nice enough. Yeah, I'm pretty happy. I don't love... I know this is not a big deal, but I don't like this big slab. It's just... it's too big. I like details. I like thing. I like stuff. I like things to be just jam-packed with stuff. And there isn't enough stuff, and it makes me sad. I thought you should know that. We also need to do the signpost. Anyways. Oh, we'll do it now. Whatever. Right, bison and pronghorn. Anyways. What was I saying? No idea. Something important. Oh, yeah. So, is that gonna fit? I'm just gonna put pronghorn. Yeah? Yeah. I have always been looking for what it is I'm gonna do, and I've gone through the ringer. It's been a long ass list, ladies and gentlemen. Let me tell you that much. There has been a long list of things I have considered doing. I've been to university for, you know, I graduated in. Maybe grizzlies? I think that looks okay. You know, I graduated in biomedical science, which obviously has nothing to do with what I'm doing now. My first degree was actually in linguistics. I dropped out through year and then went into biomedical science. Let's put wolves. Cool. Am I just going to talk about myself this entire video? Yeah, apparently. Anyways, what else needs love? I think this bit is obviously very blank right now. As is this bit here, but this is all going to become stuff anyway, so I want to leave that alone for now. I really like this bit. I actually really like this, my little modern art thing. I think it's really cool. I don't know, I think it's cool anyway. What's this in? Also, these doors, I actually don't... like, I'd love to do these in the video, but I have no idea what I'm going to do about them. And what goes on that doorway. I do like this. I'm still thinking of making it Jurassic Park inspired. I kind of want to just build Jurassic Park. But yeah, I mean, it's already slightly Jurassic Park inspired, but I don't really know how, what else to do. I have tried stuff and it didn't quite work out. What else do we need to do anyway? That's done. That's much. I mean, it's cool, isn't it? I think it's really pretty. And you're really pretty. That's right, you YouTube. Oh, we need to do lights. Let's go over here. So I've done this back wall. There's many, many lights on it, as you can see. Now we need to put them on the right hand wall and the roof. So. This will take a while. Let's just get to work. Boop. Boop, 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 boop. Anyways, so, been around the ringer, searching for what I want to do. Because at the end of the day, I want to do something I'm passionate about. You know, I've been given a lot of, you know, help in life from my dad and a lot of support and love and stuff like that, which even that is something a lot of families don't get, you know, or don't give to their kids, which is a shame. It really is. Like, people are under this impression that, you know, you choose what you want to do at 18 and then you're locked in for life. And it's sad in a lot of ways, because at the end of the day, like, who knows what they want to do at 18? Some people do and they'll be right and they'll be fine forever. But for a lot of people, you're not going to have a bloody clue. And rightly so, but you're 18. You're still forming, essentially. You know, you're not who you are yet. You know, people are changing constantly. That's why so many people change careers later on. Anyways, what are we about? So yeah, I've been thinking for a long time, and even like over the last week or so, I've gone back and forth like 25 times trying to just find something, because at the end of the day, like, it sounds sad, but there's not that much I feel, and there's causes I feel passionate about, and I'm very passionate about dinosaurs, and very passionate about animals, and I've considered looking into that as a area. What that would be, I don't know yet, but you know, that could be an option. Passionate about writing, although I don't do it enough. Reading, I don't think I can do that professionally. But at the end of the day, it's like I struggle to find things I'm truly, truly passionate about. There isn't that much. That is nuts. That is way too many big lights on the roof. Way too many. I kill about half of them. And I don't know how many people know this. I watch quite a lot of films. I have a Letterboxd account, which is like a film rating site, and I review every single film I watch, and I track them, and I count them, and I have, you know, a big running tally of reviews and lists each year of every film that I've watched. There's a subreddit called 365 Movies, where they do like a little challenge to watch 365 films, which I always think sounds really cool, right? Because it's at the end of the day, like, watch those films, see lots of indie stuff you would never seen, become a better film critic, all this kind of jazz, you know, embrace the media in general. And I tried it last year. I tried it the year before last, actually. I think I got like 90 or something on my first attempt. I tried it again last year. Started off really well. Last year, I watched all of the Lord of the Rings films, Extended Edition, in like a day or something. And then I watched the entire, for some reason, the Resident Evil saga. It was like 6 films. I watched all of them, which was a bad idea. Actually, you know what? I didn't hate them as much as I thought I would. And then I watched, like, don't get me wrong, I've been watching some good films as well, but, I mean, Lord of the Rings is a classic. You know what I mean? Arty films, essentially. Anyways, the point is I gave the challenge a go. This is a long-winded story to get to absolutely nowhere. oh my god. That was last year. Well, last year I got to 167 films or something like that. It's still quite a lot. Decent, but not as many as I wanted, obviously. There's a quick way to do this. So no, because it's not going in straight. I mean, it's okay. I don't really want details on the side. This is meant to be the main bit. But I just wanted the sides to be part of it, you know? Have it more immersive. I might still use this for the wolves. I'm not sure yet. We'll see. For the Arctic Wolves. We could build an Arctic Wolf thing there. We could just do our Tundra Zone over here. We could do an Arctic Wolf exhibit. But we'll have a little think about that. I don't know for sure. It's set up for it, if need be, basically. Anyways. Let's grab more of these. So, yeah. Anyways, I started doing it again this year. Just been going to sleep or whatever. I just stick a couple films on. Or especially because I've been sick lately. I've not really been able to do much else. So, just watch some films, I guess. Watch some good films. What have I seen this year? I'll talk about films for a minute before I continue my story. I watched 3 films tonight, I'm not gonna lie. I woke up, I've been sleeping horribly the last few days because of this illness. I never know when I'm awake or when, like, I don't have a sleeping time at the moment. I just sort of drift in and out all day, so I never really know when I'm gonna be awake. It's made planning for work very difficult, but it means to kill time, and because I can't really do much else because I'm dead, I've been watching a lot of films. So I watched 3 today. I watched The Witch, finally. I can't believe I've never seen The Witch before. The Witch is brilliant, by the way. Like, I read quite a lot of negative comments. I'm not really sure why. I think if you're a fan of, like, folklore and slow-burn horror films, it's one of the best the genre has. It's up there with maybe even better than The Ritual, which I really liked. But you have to be into that kind of horror. You really do. Obviously. what are these cheeky little buggers doing? Also, there's definitely some outside now, isn't there? Yeah. Oh god, there's tons. That's fine. Nah, it's not a big deal. I mean, we'll get rid of them, obviously. Probably easy to check at night time. Looking good, though. Looking sexy. What's from here? This is a weird dead spot. Anyways. Watched... What did I... Oh, The Endless, which is like this Lovecraftian psychedelic horror film with amazing reviews, and I've got to be honest, I thought it was fairly underwhelming. I thought it was pretty mediocre. It seems I've got a thing against films. Like, I really like intelligent, thought-provoking, smart films in general, you know. Anything that presents unique ideas, and it definitely had those, but it was one of these films that's very... It felt like it was trying to convince me it was more intelligent than it actually was, and it had more unique ideas. And it came across as a little bit annoying in that sense, and I don't think it was as clever as it thinks it was. Does that make any sense? I think that makes sense. Anyway, so it was alright, but I wouldn't watch it again. I think I gave it like a 5 out of 10. Obviously not out of 5. Oh, this bit's gonna be hard. I was dreading the roof. It's fine for the big ones. Wait, can I just duplicate this? Will that work? No, but I think it might be easy to sync in like that and just do each one individually. What if I do align to surface? Yeah, that's better. And then we just sync. That's how we're gonna have to do this. It's gonna be a pain in the ass. Oh well. On the plus side, it'll make them all a little bit more unique because they're all gonna be slightly different depths inside. Anyways, so The Witch, which I loved, I'm going to give like 9 out of 10. Like I said, I review and rate everything I watch. And The Endless, which was a solid... I'm going between a 4 and a 5. I'm tempted to give it 4, but 4 is a very low rating. Probably a 5. It was average. Had some cool ideas, but execution a little bit shoddy. And it was ugly as well. So ugly. I mean, the colour grading and camera work was ugh. Anyways. And I just watched the Mayoritz stories, which is like a Noah Baumbach film with Adam Sandler and what's his face? I can't remember, Ben Stiller, which sounds negative on the front of it, but it's actually very, very good, like a very good comedy, drama, family. It's Noah Baumbach, you know what you're getting with Baumbach. Baumbach. The guy who did Marriage Story, which I still haven't seen, but I'm going to see Marriage Story. I might watch Marriage Story when I finish this video. I was falling behind on my 366, it's a leap year, so it's 366 films in 366 days. I was falling behind because I've been sick, and whilst I've got lots of free time because I've been sick, it's quite hard to watch films sometimes because I really want to concentrate on the film. I have to give films my full attention. Like, I get really annoyed. Like, people keep getting annoyed with me because I get annoyed at them. Like, if they start talking during a scene or something, I'll pause it and look at them. And people take it really negatively. I'm just thinking, you know, I want to focus on the film, right? But if you want to talk and it's important, then I'll pause it and we can talk. I want to give you my focus. I don't want to be dividing my focus between two things. I'm not valuing one of those things over the other. I'm kind of valuing them over the film, but don't do it while the film's on. That's all I'm saying. Anyways. What was I saying? I have no idea. Oh, I did watch a film yesterday, though, which I gave 5 out of 5. 10 out of 10, I should say. In our rating system. Which I very, very rarely do. I've done it for, like... I think, like... I've got, like, 400 films rated, and I think I've given 10 out of 10 to about... 8, 9, something like that. There's a film, I think it's... I want to say it's Korean, but I don't want to seem racist. It's East Asian. It's Korean or Japanese or something. I believe it's Korean. But I really don't know for sure. I'm like 80% sure it's Korean. Anyways. I can't remember the director's full name. It's Uheida or something like that. It's called One Cut of the Dead. Which, if you're into films at all, like, or just filmmaking as an art form, I highly recommend. It's a horror comedy, but to be honest, it has basically zero horror elements. It's definitely more of a comedy. And to talk about the twist or what goes on would be to ruin it. This is taking bloody ages. Would ruin it, but suffice to say, it's incredibly intelligent and genius filmmaking and completely surprising and plays with genre conventions in just the best way. It's such a good film. I can't remember the last film I 5 out of 5 10 out of 10 before that, but it's been a while. This is driving me absolutely up the wall. Can I just... I can't even... I'm so bored of doing the lights. Can I just end it there? Oh my god, that bit's not done at all. Right, powering through now. I'm gonna look at this bit anyway, who cares? I wonder if there's a better way to do this. I think I could probably have made a line of these baubles, you know, like this, just bam, 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 bam. And then sank in like tons of them at once rather than doing it individually. That might have been... That'll do. And that's gonna look really cool at night. I will say, that's gonna look awesome at night. This room needs a little bit of love. What I love is like, I want like beanbag chairs and stuff, you know? I want like fabric and soft stuff. I really want this to be a nice cozy room. It's meant to be a, you know, all the kids come in and there's a presentation, they sit down and some guy comes in and goes, "Space, the final frontier," and then it's like, bah, it's all dramatic. That's why there's curtains, you know, and the curtain pole, because they want to block the light. I think at the very least, what we need is more benches. There needs to be more seating than this. Maybe it doesn't need seating at the back. Maybe the back seating makes no sense. Maybe it's more a line or two lines right at the front. The problem with the benches is you can't actually bloody, you can't duplicate them. They're weird. Like, I can duplicate it like that, yeah, but I can't control X. You know, I can't just drag it in a line, essentially. I don't have a clue why. It's a very weird little limitation. I just want to click and control X and put it where I want directly. You know, I want it to be... You can never have them perfectly in the right spot because the game literally doesn't let you. I just think that's super weird. Why is this side of the room smaller than this side of the room? It can't be. It makes no sense. This room does need a little bit more love. The walls are very bare. I did start doing some blotting out in the wood. I'm trying to think what we can do. I think like an info wall. It's going to be a planetarium slash wolf building. I'm still not sure if I'll bring the wolves in, but... Sorry, drink break. Even if we don't, it does look like a spaceship, doesn't it? It can still be wolf-themed, alright? Because we're in a wolfy area, wolves are a big part of Black Rock's history, so the wolves can still be part of it, and they were definitely part of my original image for it, so I don't want to get rid of them, even if the actual wolves themselves aren't part of it, which they weren't anyway, originally. I mean, that's going to look really cool at night. Need more lights here, but whatever. So what would you put? I'm just thinking about... I don't have a bloody clue. Ow! This bloody wire, I swear. I'm thinking like just some education boards and... I'm gonna ponder on that for a little bit. I think we need to write the story of the ghost. Now lots of people gave me suggestions for this and I completely forgot to look at any of them, so I'm gonna make it up as we go along. So, you know what? I was super proud of this bit. I think that looked really cool. Anyways. The Tale of the Ghost. So the ghost of Blackrock is this lovely bison over here, who's been here since before the settlers came. Which is, I've always found settlers a bad term, because it's, right, the idea is the settlers came, as in technically the British, I suppose, and then who became the Americans along with a bunch of other people. But people were already settled here, they're just not you, they're not, you know, they were natives, just because they were there already, like... Yeah, I don't know. You can't settle where someone's already settled. Get out. Anyways, the Tale of the Ghost. I don't know American history. When was America... Where's my phone? I need to know, when did, like, modern America start? When did England go to America? Or Britain or whatever. Jamestown was 1607. Ow. Long ago in the 1500s, so we just want to set the scene. It's all nice. Everyone's happy. So, long ago, blah, blah, blah. The bison and the Native Americans. Lived in... harmony together. Ooh. That's not me being terrible at typing. The N key on my keyboard is screwed. I'm just wondering if I don't want to do capital letters. It'll trigger me a little bit not to, but it is meant to be a continuous... Yeah. I'm going to capitalize bison, though, just to try to emphasize their importance. Yeah, you see that the double N. Like, I didn't even notice it. It happens all the time. It's just the N key. The others... The J and the K, it's that little area. The J, the K, and the N are the bad ones, but the N in particular is a pain in the ass. See what I mean? Long ago in the 1500s, the bison and the Native Americans lived in harmony together on the plains of Black Rock. I'm going to say 1600s. Obviously, they lived together prior to that, but 1600s is when our story takes place. So, long ago in the 1600s, the bison and the Native Americans lived in harmony together on the plains. Upon the plains is nicer. I want to add a little bit of zhuzh. Upon the plain, for God's sake. If I'm going to get back into writing, I'm going to have to change my keyboard. Long ago, the Native Americans lived in harmony together upon the plains of Black Rock. Until... I really don't like using the word suddenly in writing. I know I'm writing a signpost in Planet Zoo, but come on! Until one... Oh my god, this N key. Till one sun-drenched Monday morn, when the blade of the white man struck. And there's the K doing the same thing. Don't want people to have like a thing about me constantly saying white man in this situation. This is kind of like how it was referred to quite often, actually, and still is, actually. If you watch, honestly, my favorite reference for this is Parks and Recreation, but the guy who runs the casino, and that is kind of meant to be a play in the program, calls it, well, white man, and uses it as like a rebuttal, essentially, the way he says it, anyway. But it's not meant to be, it doesn't have to be a big deal, let's put it that way. Although my park goers would take issue with that. People always take issue with the stupidest stuff, they really do. But that's what happened. White people came over and caused havoc. That's essentially what happened. Like, it's stupid to pretend otherwise. It's stupid to, like, pretend your own... Like, it's not even your own people or whatever. I mean, technically, it is my own predecessors long, long ago. It's stupid to pretend people didn't do some fucked up stuff, essentially. It wasn't that long ago that people were doing slavery. It really wasn't that long ago. Bloody France was beheading people, like, 40 years ago, 50 years ago. Was it like 1990 or something? They beheaded someone? I can't remember. It really wasn't that... I'm gonna Google this. This is important. I think, I swear it was super recent. Like, in my lifetime. Maybe not in my life. Oh, Android system update. What are you doing to me? Please stop. Please stop. Right, well, that's going to do its thing. Long ago in the 1600s, Bison and Native Americans lived in harmony together upon the... It's actually doing a bloody phone update. Upon the plains of Black Rock. Until one sun-drenched Monday morn when the blade of the white man struck. This is going to be longer than I wanted. Okay. I think the bison has to die here. Maybe I can bring some of these ones together. That's probably a better idea. I was going to go for natives, just bring it in, because even that doesn't fit. I'm going back to on instead of upon. That's right, I'm saying mourn, I'm being that person. There we go, right, oh, that doesn't work. What about that? Nearly. What about just during the... It's not as pithy, but even this isn't quite working. Okay. Better. Yeah. Okay, cool. We're in business. Phew. Life, eh? I still want to know when this beheading was. My point is, we're not as civilized as we think we are. And the stuff people do now and get away with, fine. That people will look back on in 50 years and think you're just animals. Essentially, might be all technically animals, but you know what I mean. Am I ending the sentence with that? I think so. Cold? This is very limited writing ability. The herd was slain and the natives culled. No, because they're not. They're not all slaves. Well, they are, yeah. Okay, then I'm going to change that up. Battle was fierce. Blood spilled freely. I was going to go worse, but children will read this. How do I write this? Let me think about this. The battle was fierce, blood spilled freely. The attackers came in great numbers. No, wait. No, that's not like either. Really can't write like this. This is very limiting. I've got like 7 words to write so much. Oh my god. During the 1600s, bison natives lived in harmony upon Black Rock Plain. Notice how the bison are first. Bison are very important. Until one sudden stretch, not more important than humans, but they're important, more important than here. Until one sudden stretch, Monday morning, when the blade of the white man struck the bat was fierce, blood spilled freely. And few but the chief remained grieving. Now, this is interesting. Was the ghost of Black Rock always white? Or, and yes, I'm seeing the irony in the white man attacked and caused all these problems and then the ghost of Black Rock was white. No, he's white because he's a ghost. Okay. Yeah, I see. I'm just gonna ham it up until... Alpha bison. Imagine being an alpha bison. Stompig. Is that a Pokemon? Stomping and huffing? Growling? The bison growl? I kinda... Yeah, fuck it, growl. Sorry. Feral was took until the alpha bison leapt to his defense. This allowed the chief and his family to escape. Come on, fit. Ah, you cheeky little so-and-so. And so the chief and his family escaped. Alpha Bison leapt to his defense, and so the chief and his family escaped. Ah! Ah! I hate not being able to just write! I'm not even trying to like be particularly... Like, when I write, usually I'm a very colorful writer. Like, my lecturers all... Like, other than my English lecturer, who totally got me, for obvious reasons, my other lecturers always... got onto me, because I'm very much, I tend to flourish as much as humanly possible, and it's very hard to write like this for me. It really is. Oh, I really wish I was better at it. It's probably one of the reasons I didn't stick with lore as well. You have to be very, to the point. If you're writing a letter to a client, you can't go on and be all descriptive and colourful, and I really want to be, so. Death did come, though, but for the bison. Sad face. Many moons later, on plains fresh and safe. I want to write more! Maybe I can get 5 lines in here. Is that crazy? I don't think that's crazy. I think we need to do it. I actually don't think I can fit in enough to do it like this. Oh, whatever. Now it's bloody fine as it is. Right, that'll do. Ghost done. That took bloody ages. Okay, so where we at? What actually needs doing? You know what? I need nighttime. I want to do the lights for this. Also want to keep an eye on my money. Hello, profit. Who's looking profitable? Maybe. Good timing. Wait, what? What? No, no, I'm sorry. I've made a terrible... I think that was my staff wages. That's the thing. You look okay. Oh, my God. Oh. I thought it was going all right. These bloody wolves. I swear, I was actually profitable before the wolves. The exhibit's too big. This is too big. It's very hard to make money with exhibits like this. I could do with more education. I mean, I'm making money. Technically. Like, my day-to-day running at the park is profitable. And then the staff wages come out. I think it's the staff wages. And suddenly my money just gets absolutely tanked. Which is, don't get me wrong, totally fair enough. But it's also a pain in the ass. Any more grizzly Bengal tigers? I'm only interested in golds. Oh, whatever. Who cares? I've got plenty of cons. When I get down to like 10,000 credits, then oh god, this wasn't worth much. No, that one's better. When I get back to about 10,000 credits, I'll start to worry again. There we go. That's all I needed. Anywho, looks nicer, doesn't it? Hey, ah, oh, that's pretty. Pollution bad by. So this is meant to be the Earth dying, basically. There you go. It looks like the red one should be the last one. This is actually meant to be black, and that's the idea. Maybe I'll just get the light out. Now I think about it. That makes more sense. So that's like, it's green and verdant, and then it's like Mars-ish, and then it's just dead entirely. It's very deep. There we go. That's the tale of the ghost. Come to life. There he is right there, the ghost of Blackrock. With the shackles that bound him. Which aren't in the story, but that's okay. Can't really do much about that right now. You know what I need? Some, let me check my education. Shoot, it's awful. Yeah, we need more speakers. What's going on over here? I mean, it's always bugged me. There you go. It's fine. Whatever. Yeah, I'm just gonna move this, actually, to the feet of the bear. That way we can get a little bit more education in, like so. There we go. Beautiful. Beautiful. Okay. Oh, right. Ooh. I've not seen this at night. That's pretty sweet. I like that. Oh, we have seen it at night, didn't we? Because we saw the inside of the carts. I think I can fix that. I'm wondering if the exhibit needs lights. It's just, it's very dark at night. And it should be, that makes a lot of sense, but I don't know, do you ever light up an exhibit? What does Zeus look like at night? Also, when was that beheading? So many questions. So many important questions. I really like this video. Can I just say, like, I've really enjoyed this video. I know that's nonsense, but I've had a great time. When was the last beheading? 1977. That's crazy. I mean, that was in, yeah, 1977 in France. That's mad, right? It's not that long ago. It's 13 years before I was born. Last someone got beheaded. People are still obviously. People got sentenced to. When did they get sentenced? Was it beheading? No. Five people just got sentenced to death in Indonesia, I want to say. I can't remember. Philippines? It was somewhere. Southeast Asia. The fact that the death sentence still exists is mind-boggling. What was I doing? Oh yeah, what was the other thing? I want to see, like, a zoo exhibit at night. Because the fact that zoos aren't usually open at night, right? London Zoo actually does a very cool thing where you can go and, oh, it's super cool. You can go around at night. It's really, really cool. You can actually stay overnight at London Zoo. It's really awesome. But, I've not managed to go yet, so... They do have lights. Where would you put the lights? Just kind of hide them amongst the trees and stuff. Should we try it? We should light... I really want to get some lights in here. We'll just see if we can do it without it looking totally stupid. And if we can't. It's not a big deal. But I don't want them to be noticeable during the daytime, you know? Let's have a little peek. I think I'll notice that one. Right, can we just, like, hide these... I kind of want the position snap off. And then you gotta put it back down again so it's flat. Oh, no, no. I don't know. And you can see that now. Maybe we can sink it down further for one. But I think... You can't see it from here, which is what's important. And I don't think you'd be able to see it during the day. Or barely, anyway. I think that's kind of cute. I'm gonna go with this. I think it's a good idea. Is that flat? My wolvens. The lights. Maybe a little bit over, like, under the waterfall. Yeah. Hide it behind the rock, though. Nice. Very cool. Very sexy. Technically, I just hide them completely under the ground. It still works. But that's not a good example. Like, over here. See? The problem with that is, it's not realistic. I'm a man of science. Like, I don't need it super realistic. I don't know. Do I like that? I think I like that. I think that's pretty cool. It's not a big deal. Like, I'm sure most people do this in their exhibits. I don't usually bother. Let's look up here. It's gonna look worse from up here, but that's okay. This is really the viewpoint I've been basing a lot of the design around, so. I'm gonna stick like that for now. It doesn't need more than that. That's fine. Oh, that's cute! I like it. I forgot I need to do this bit. No idea what we're going to put there. Anyways. So, what I've been thinking is we need lights. I love that. I want lights here as well. Ooh, how do I light you up? I was thinking like this. What am I thinking of? Like a, it's like a oil lamp kind of looking thing. Yeah, I think that's fine, actually. Okay, I'll do it. Yep, that'll do. So I don't know what to do for lampposts for this whole area here. I'm mostly considering just doing the lights in the path like I've been doing there. It might look a little weird to just kind of stop it, but I also like the idea of this being a little bit... It's a little bit less modern. It's still modern, but the lights in the path is sort of hyper-modern, you know? It's got a very modern look to it. I love this park.
I should point this out. I adore this park. I really do. I don't know, though. I actually think that might look better. You'd be able to track the entire park just through... Why is there a gap there? I still can't decide. I think part of the problem is that I can't find a lamppost that I like. I mean, this one was tempting. But I think that colour's gonna look weird. I don't think it fits. I mean, it obviously looks better. Wait, there you go. It looks better now, but... Nah, it doesn't fit at all. At the end of the day, it's still a modern park, so we'd have to go for a modern lamppost. This is like... I think this is what I used inside. Is this what I used inside? Oh no, I didn't use them inside. I did have lampposts inside, I got rid of them. I mean, that's not bad. Maybe turn it to the side. Maybe sink it in a little bit. I know this doesn't seem like a big deal, but it is. It genuinely is. I actually think the way I've been doing it, just to keep doing this, might make the most sense. It's also the least obtrusive. It's less likely to... Yeah. Okay. Right, that's a disaster. Like, just looking at it from here, I can see that's a disaster. It's just wrong. We're gonna grab one here. I'm gonna make a new set, and it's gonna be beautiful. It's gonna be perfectly aligned. Alright? You hear me, world? So I'm just gonna have to, I'm just gonna put them there. It's gonna be part of the path. Okay, so. Perfect. Wait, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna move this one. What I need to set is like a marker, so it sits to just on to the line there of the board. Yeah? Is that about the right distance? No, further than that. I'll go one more across. Two more, maybe. There instead. Yeah. That's about right. Okay. So grab him. So there's... Oh my god. Right, so you go across. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7... Wait, what? From this... Right, so it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yes, okay. So you go 7 from the one on the left. So that's one on the left. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This will get much quicker once I've done it like a couple of times. There you go. And again. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Do people see what I'm doing? Meow. So look how quick this is gonna be. Zoom, folks. Also becomes slightly annoying, must be said. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It's there. Yeah, that's gonna look cool, and it does what I want. It, which has always been this fusion of the modern and the natural. We've got a very, very sort of naturalistic looking area here. So it'd be cool to bring in a few modern elements. It's there. That is far enough to the end. Oh no, do you bend? Oh, you bend. Why do you bend? You're not meant to bend. Cheeky little so-and-so. Right. Okay. So. I'm not going to do all this now, don't worry about it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 to there. Why do you bend? I know, like, I know I made you do that. You didn't magically do it on your own, but still, why? Do, 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 do. And we'll just finish off being a little slacking. There you go. I think that's the right call. Yeah. What I do want is one more in this corner right here. Sit in the middle. It's going to look really nice. That's not going to be super exciting. I know this is kind of clean-up stuff, but I'll sit through it. I'll do that on my own. So this will all be lit up, hopefully. Do I get rid of them? The reason we got rid of the wooden pathing is because I can't really do it for this, because you can't tilt this stuff. Doesn't tilt. So I can't do it for the bridge, so I thought I'd just get rid of the whole thing. I'm still not convinced by this, you know. It looks nice, but I still want lampposts. I'm going to think about that. That's the main reason, to be honest, is I kind of want to think it over. I think we're basically done with... Oh, no, one last thing. One last thing. What do we do here? Do we have anything in, I don't know, centerpieces or... There we go. This terrifying little reindeer. That's what we need. What we need is some lights into the area first. Do do do. I just want light, just so I can see what I'm doing. Ah, that is super close to the edge of that, isn't it? Yeah. Yeah. Wow. That's the limit right there. Centerpieces. So. Ooh. Yes. Beautiful. Look at that stunner. Can't go wrong with a dodo ice sculpture. I've always said that even before Planet Zoo. Can't go wrong with a dodo ice sculpture. Got enough wolf sculptures. I don't need more. I don't need more bison. As much as I love the bison. Same thing. I don't really need any of these. This is the thing. I don't have this bear. Can I do anything with this bear? I can do a lot of this bear, believe me. What are you doing, bear? It doesn't have to be much. It can just be a... Oh. It can just be a forest bit. It really can. It's just meant to provide a way to loop around with the... I could even get rid of the path here. So you walk around there like... Oh, that must... I wonder what that would look like. I don't hate it. Yeah, I quite like that, actually. And I've discovered a way to put bins not on the path. I actually did not know you could do that. I thought they maybe just went away automatically. So that's actually pretty cool. I can't remember to put bins everywhere. Okay, cool. I'm pretty sure we're just going to put a little forest in here. We may put the bear in. Don't get me wrong. I love the bear, but... For now, I'm just going to stick some trees in, really. My usual suspects... Baby suspect. Oh, a little baby suspect. That'd be adorable. Okay, it's a little... I mean, obviously, we're going to have lights in here. It's just nice. It feels more like a dark forest, sort of. I'm down with that. Dark, spooky forest. You see the lights of the staff building there. Maybe you'll catch a glimpse of some people working. Yeah, there he is. There's Bob. I'm going to go for Joe and Bob at the same time. I got Bob. Seymour Royale, I was close. Get some lights in these trees and stuff like that, and yeah, so Black Rock Park. I still don't know what I'm gonna do for the lights, so I'll think about that. Other than that, we are basically caught up. So next time we do the videos. Oh. Gotta check on the planetarium. Yeah, oh, look at that. That's pretty cool. Okay, I kind of want the wolves to sleep in here. I think that's going to look really cool. Yeah, I want the wolves to sleep in there. Okay. We could even make it snow! Oh my god, we could actually make it snow. I like that idea as well. Okay, I mean, like I said, we could do the Arctic wolves could, in theory, live here. I would be okay with that. Every animal could live in this park, in the new set, other than the polar bear. And then maybe we'll have like a little area where we... I think we may just do a tundra section, to be honest, guys. And we'll bring in the polar bear and say it's like a guest exhibit animal. Well, habitat animal. That we've sort of brought in from the Arctic. Because at the end of the day, we can't make an Arctic zoo. Because there's only the polar bear. So, the polar bear either has to be in here, or it's not going to get a zoo. Or it's going to get its own zoo, which would also be silly, so... That's the direction I'm leaning. I think that's a pretty good idea. And that means we can use this for the Arctic wolves, which I know a lot of people were disappointed that we didn't do. So I'd like to do that. I think it looks so cool. I really like that, yeah. Can I make it the thumbnail twice? It's already the thumbnail for one of the videos, but it just looks baller. This is one of the better ideas I've had. I don't have many great ones, but this is one of the better ones. But we'll see how we feel about that. Let me know what you think in the comments down below. I think I'll do the Arctic Wolves. I still need to do... We're probably going to do the exhibit animals next. I also really want to light this up somehow. Kind of tempted to put, like, you know, the lights like we do here. But along the rims of that, I think that would look awesome. I also think it would take about 10,000 hours, so I'll have to definitely consider whether that's something I want to commit to doing. But we'll think about it, we'll think about it. I hope you've enjoyed this video. I know it was an hour and a half, which is longer than our usual by quite a distance. Next video will either be the Arctic Wolves, which we'll do there, or the exhibit animals, which will be somewhere. This is my one form of it. I want to do the exhibit animals here, but we could do that. We could do the Arctic Wolves, like, there and there. And our exhibit animals there, and then you go through the science center, and that leads you to the tundra center. So you can either view the Arctic Wolves from here, or you can walk through the exhibit area, the science bit, and into the tundra zone, and see the Arctic Wolves amongst everything else. Is that the play? That might be the play. You guys let me know what you think. If you enjoyed this video, please do let me know. Hit that like button, all that kind of jazz. Again, I do apologize, it's been so long since the content and stuff, you know, I've been immensely ill. I really have. This was still a little bit of a struggle. It might be a low-key week, but we are at the very least back. We'll come back tomorrow with some campaigns, some Jurassic World Evolution. We're going to finish off JPOG Park finally and get started on some new stuff on that. That's going to be really cool. Thank you so much for joining me. I'll see you lovely folks next time. Cheers much love as always. Bye-bye. Hey folks, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video, you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way, I'll see you next time.